Protein powder, how to use it to lose fat and build muscle. Protein was first marketed in the early 1990s. Before it was found that whey promoted muscle growth and had a large market waiting for it, whey was considered a waste product and disposed of. I remember purchasing my first protein powder knowing nothing about nutrition and training. As the months went by and seeing the progress I was making, I thought it was completely due to this magic tub. Protein powder is by far the most consumed supplement and staple in most athletes' diets for a good reason. It's digested quickly, absorbed efficiently, and easy on the taste buds. In this video, I'll show you how to use it to lose fat and build muscle. But before we dive in, a lot of research and editing goes into making a video like this. Just do me one favor, if you wouldn't mind, gently hit the like button. It would be greatly appreciated. And if you enjoy this kind of content, subscribe and hit the notification bell if you're new. Let's kick it off. So, how to decide which protein is best? The first thing you need to know, there really isn't a single type of protein powder that is best for everyone. The key is finding what is best for you. Some people do well with dairy derivatives and some don't. Some want to stick with a plant-based protein powder and others just want whatever will work best. Many want to limit their intake of artificial ingredients and they aren't sure what they should and shouldn't avoid. Well, let's take an in-depth look at each of these things and make a more narrowed down base choice of protein powder. Whey is a byproduct of cheese production. It's a relatively clear fluid left over after milk has been curdled and strained and is used to be disposed of as waste. Whey, especially popular with athletes and bodybuilders, because of its amino profile, which is high in leucine. Leucine is an essential amino acid that plays a key role in initiating protein synthesis. Time and time again in the literature, whey protein has been described to be a staple in athletes' diets to build muscle. Devries and colleagues describe consumption of whey protein as a robust ability to stimulate muscle protein synthesis. In fact, whey protein has been found to stimulate muscle protein synthesis to a greater degree than other proteins. That being said, I've consistently been asked about its safety on the kidney and liver. A 2019 network meta-analysis concluded that whey protein has been widely accepted as safe to use, granted there's no pre-existing damage to those organs. Which leads to the next common question. So, to answer which protein is best for you, personally for me, I look at which protein allows me to build the most amount of muscle possible and also to be able to burn fat at the same time. And when I look at that, it depends on the number of carbs and fats within that protein. And for me, it's whey isolate. Isopept has the highest quality amount of protein in it with also very little carbs and basically no fats. And chocolate peanut butter is my favorite flavor. The proteins you're seeing in front of you, I've linked them in the description below. And if you want to save yourself some cash and support me, you can use a discount code DIAMONDS10 at checkout. Now, if you're a person who still wants to make gains and you're a vegan or want to rather go for a plant-based protein, pea protein is the way to go. However, this is 23 grams of protein as compared to 25. Bigger picture, I would advise rather having 2 scoops of this just to make sure that you're having adequate amounts of protein from your protein powder. And another example is just the lean whey. This one has slightly more carbs in it and slightly less protein, but not enough to make a big difference. So in the end of the day, it depends on the brand you trust and what your specific goals are. How can protein help you lose fat? When referring to hunger and appetite, we closely follow 2 hormones. GLP-1 and ghrelin, also known as the hunger hormone. A high protein diet induces satiety, thermogenesis. It increases your metabolic rate, your protein balance, which improves your muscle protein synthesis and fat burning. Ghrelin, the hormone that makes you feel hungry, is decreased, and GLP-1 decreases your food intake through increased satiety. Therefore, adding a scoop or two of whey protein can help you with maintaining and sticking to a caloric restricted diet and achieving one's desired results. But how much protein should you consume? A 2014 study showed that a 20 gram dose of whey protein is sufficient for maximal stimulation of post-absorptive rates of myofibrillar muscle protein synthesis. A more interesting study by McNaughton and colleagues indicated ingestion of 40 grams of whey protein following whole body resistance exercise stimulates a greater muscle protein synthesis response than 20 grams in young resistance trained men. My personal advice? Eating 1 gram of protein per pound of weight. For example, giving a 200 pound male 200 grams of protein. Allotting 20 to 40 grams of the 200 grams of whey protein is acceptable to the rest of the protein should be accumulated from whole foods for extra minerals and microelements. How protein powder increases the muscle mass and boosts your metabolism. Whey protein is one of the highest quality proteins given its amino acid content, high in essential branched chain and leucine amino acid content, and its rapid digestibility. Consumption of whey protein has the powerful ability to stimulate muscle protein synthesis. In fact, whey protein has been found to stimulate muscle protein synthesis to a greater degree than all the other proteins. And when is the best time to consume protein powder? Multiple studies have shown that having whey pre-workout to be beneficial, or having it post-workout if you're in a fasted state. Looking at the bigger picture, when you take the supplement, it won't be the straw that breaks the camel's back, but to make sure you consume enough protein at the end of the day. Which leads us to our next argument. What about plant proteins versus a whey protein? For gaining muscle, animal protein edges out plant protein in several important ways. It contains higher amounts of essential amino acids and is generally digested and absorbed better. That doesn't mean that plant fuel athletes can't make gains though. And regardless of what types of protein you eat, remember that it's more important that it's simply eating enough protein every day. If you eat too little of the highest quality protein, you struggle to gain muscle. A 2019 study comparing the effects of whey versus pre-protein on physical adaptations concluded that ingestion of whey and pre-protein produces a similar outcome in measurements of body composition, muscle thickness, and force production. My personal recommendation is that maybe consuming a little bit more pea protein can compensate for the lack of their essential amino acids. So that is the end of the video. If you have any questions with regards to Mike, how much protein should I be consuming? Which protein should I be consuming? Anything with regards to protein, if you've had any experiences with it, let me know in the comment section down below. I hope you did enjoy the video. If you did, smash the video with a thumbs up. I'll greatly appreciate it. If you're new, subscribe. And again, if you want to support me, link in the description for these proteins and using Diamonds 10 directly supports your boy. Subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.